Hello students and friends, welcome back to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 12. Today I'll be combining both the SolidWorks session as well as the PLC in 21 days day 12 session together in a single video to tell you about how we can model, design and model the parts and assembly in SolidWorks. Then after that, if I pass on the message to the workshop people, they'll make the components either using lathe or milling machine or CNC milling machine or something. So we can assemble. Then we can introduce electronics under the PLC. The concept of PLC is used. Okay, so to develop a real product. What I'm going to show you now is a real product. We'll see one by one. So here you will be seeing the assembly of a real machine. We have feeder cum cutter. We made nearly three sets of this kind of machines. Two are in use in a company. One is with me, it is in my garage. So I have taken the video especially for your benefit. So with the set available with me here in my garage. So now let us see. Here in this particular session, you will see the full SolidWorks assembly. Okay, then after making it, automation or automating it with the use of PLC and its details we'll see, and the machine images and the real working. Okay, this particular machine requires a power supply, of course. In addition to that, you need a compressor because all the actuations are carried out by the pneumatic cylinders. So it requires a pneumatic air pressure. Okay, that's it. Now, shall we see the assembly now? Okay, we'll see the assembly now. So this is the assembly. This is the assembly actually. Okay. The key essential elements you will be seeing. You see the number of parts that I included. You see one. So these many parts I added. Okay. Now this is the moving arm. Its stroke can be decided by increasing or decreasing the length or the thickness of this particular bush, so it will move up to this only. But logically, theoretically, it moves beyond that, but actually, it cannot move beyond that. To actuate this, I provided one pneumatic cylinder here, air cylinder here. So this cylinder controls the sliding arm. Let us say this is a sliding member. Or else you'll see my the coding sheet of my PLC: moving cylinder, gripper cylinder, cutting cylinder, of course. So this is the moving cylinder, this is the moving cylinder. Then so moving cylinder is only one. Then there are four gripper cylinders, two are on the sliding member. Okay, this is one gripper cylinder. Its stroke is only just 10 mm. Okay, the movement is only 10 mm. Then this is a fixed member. Here there are two cylinders, gripper cylinders. The logic is, let me show you in side view. Okay, this side view. If this moves down, this will move up automatically. Or if this moves down, this will move up automatically. So that is the logic. That is the logic, right? So I cannot introduce a single assembly mating condition such that if I move this way, it should move the other way. So there is no single mating condition available. It may be there in SolidWorks, but I do not know. Okay, maybe. So that is the logic. Okay, these are the four gripper cylinders, two on the sliding member, two on the fixed member. So if this move up, this will move down. If this move up, this move down. That means the sheet is fed in between the slots. So if it is moved down, this moved up, that means the PVC sheet, the plastic sheet, is held firmly onto the sliding member. Okay, so there is no grip on the fixed member. So if it moves, it feeds the sheet. That is the logic. After it feeds the sheet, this will move down, this will move up. So this will arrest the movement of the plastic sheet. This will move back. That time it is not pulling the sheet, pulling or pushing the sheet. Okay, so it freely moves. So now from this it is quite evident that the sheet is fed only in the forward direction, from right to left, not from left to right, as per in this view. You got it? So this is another set. Then so now at this particular position, now the gripper cylinder is firmly holding the plastic sheet. Okay, so the gripness is released here onto the sliding side. Then at this particular position, here I provided one third air cylinder, that is a cutting cylinder. That cutting cylinder is actuated, that cuts the sheet. This is the logic. So for that, this is the third cylinder. First cylinder, moving cylinder, only one cylinder. Gripper cylinder, there are four gripper cylinders, two at a sliding member, two at a fixed member. Because it has to apply force equally, no? Now let me lift it. In the front view you can see. So the sheet is fed through this particular gap. So now you see gap is closed. Okay, so now again I repeat the logic. Initially upon power on, as per this view, the moving cylinder at the right extreme position, this gripper is on the sliding side. That means it is open. It is closed here on the grip moving sliding member side. It is open on the fixed member. Then if the moment I start the machine, this will move. Then the next thing is gripper cylinder is on. That means this will be released. This will be holding the sheet. After point one, after, so this is completed. After this, after a gap of say 0.2 seconds, this will cut and this will open. In the meantime, this will go to its original position. So this is one cycle time. Okay, so the system repeats again and again and again, continuously and endlessly. Now for this, let us see the PLC circuit. I used X0 for starting the machine. X1 is a auto switch signal. If it is off, it works only once. If it is on, it will be a continuous one. Then three modes, speed wise there are three modes. One is slow speed, second medium speed, third high speed. Input X2 is assigned with slow speed, input X3 assigned with medium speed, input 4 assigned with high speed. I'm not using X5, X6, X7. Okay. So then output there are six, but I used only three, that is sufficient. Gripper cylinder, moving cylinder, cutting cylinder. So this is the logic. Now you see, this is the ladder logic program. For the slow speed, X2 is on. Here see, X2 is on. Okay. For the medium speed, for the moderate or medium speed, X3 is on. For high speed, For high speed, X4 is on. X4 is on. So go to home. So in all the places, X0 is the start button. In addition to that, X0 is auto switch. No, if this auto switch X1 is auto switch. If X1 is on, the loop is endless. It will work continuously. So this is the line for looping, continuous looping. Okay. So X0 in conjunction with X2, if it is not on, one time. If it is on, continuous, slow speed. A moderate speed. So in the slow speed, the difference between the slow speed, moderate speed is nothing but the delay, the speed. And now I introduced K. Yeah, you see the 2 seconds it takes at one particular point. Okay, 22 seconds. Whereas here, if you see 1.2 seconds for one particular operation. For one particular operation. Where is the moderate speed? Yeah. So X0, X3 and X1 all are on medium speed, continuous loop. X0, X4 and X1 is on means high speed, continuous. Now again go back to the video. So this is the cycle program sequence. Initially all Y0, Y1, Y2 are off. That means gripper cylinder, fixed gripper is on. Okay, then moving cylinder, innermost position, cutting cylinder, no cutting. Once it is on, once the X0 is on, now it is not 0.1 second, it is okay, 0.1 second, of course. Initially gripper is on. That means now I'll tell you the operation. Now with this you will understand what I mean. Let me put instead of XXX, let me put say 0.6 second or something. Okay. Now the cycle is about to start. When it will start? It starts only when X0 is pressed. If this X0 is pressed, then gripper is on initially. For, you know, it takes 0.1 second. Okay. Now I'll show you with the help of this one also. Now gripper is on means if the gripper is off means fixed gripper is on. If the gripper is off, fixed gripper is on, moving gripper is off. Now X0 is now we switched on the machine. Now this gripper is on first. That means this is on. This is a toggle type, alternating type. So if this is on, it is automatic. This will be off automatically. Okay, because NO is connected here, NC is connected here. So it go in the reverse way, opposite way. Both will work in opposite fashion. Okay. If this is on, this is off. If this is on, this is off. So gripper is on. The duration is just 0.1 second. After that, in the next 0.6 seconds, gripper is also on. Y1 moving cylinder is on now. Moving cylinder is on now. That means the gripper is on, the moving cylinder is on for 0.6 seconds. Okay, so total on duration for the gripper is 0.1 plus 0.6, 0.7. So gripper is on still. Moving cylinder is on. So that means this the outermost, this is the innermost, maybe this is the outermost. Okay, after that for 0.1 seconds still the moving cylinder is on. Moving cylinder is on, the gripper is off now. If I didn't put anything here, that means off. That means this is released, this is on. What is the duration? Just 0.1 second. Just 0.1 second. Then after that, 0.4 second, moving cylinder is off. That means it will start moving, but sheet will not move because sheet is held firmly with this fixed member, fixed gripper. Okay, so it goes to return stroke. There are two operations. This is operation one. The next operation in this particular point is Y2, cutting cylinder is on. These two things will happen simultaneously. That is, it moves this way, it cuts. Both will be functioning parallelly. Okay, after 0.4 seconds, just for 0.1 second, the this also will be off. The cutting also will be off. So cutting also will be off means from here it moves out. So this is the logic, right? You see, I think if you are able to understand, well and good. So otherwise, I can't say how I can make you to understand about these things, right? So this is the logic. Okay, so for that only we wrote the program. So output actuation, the M11 gripper cylinder is on. So we'll correlate this one, gripper cylinder is on. After that, maybe M12 or M22. Then forward cylinder, both M1 gripper cylinder and moving feeder M12. So this is how we made the program actually, right? Anyway, I'll give you this file also as PDF in the attachment, right? So this is the logic. So this is very important. Based on this only, you have to write the ladder logic, right? So this is a good way of writing a program actually, right? I can't elaborate much because it has three modes, you know, slow speed, medium speed, high speed, and actuations and all. So you just see M11, M12, M13, M14, M15, or we'll see the high speed. That will be better. 31, 32, M33, M34, M35, M36. So 31, 32. What is that? Gripping cylinder. 31, 32. These two on. Corresponds to 31, 32. Then let us see the moving cylinder. That means 32, 33. You see that 32, 33, the moving cylinder or feeder cylinder. 32, 33, only on these three, in between 31 to 36. Okay, between 31 to 36. For the gripper cylinder is on only on 31 and 32. So these two corresponds to 31 and 32. That means it is 32, 33. 32, 33. This is 33, 34. We'll check it. 31, 32. For feeder cylinder, 32, 33. For the cutter cylinder, 33, 34. So 35 is free for all. It is off on 33. 33 as well as 36 also maybe. Okay, if you see that before that 36, well, 35, 36, just 0.4, 0.2 seconds only. Okay, so this is how we read a program. So writing, this is the logic actually. Okay, if you have this logic, if you have written the logic like this, you can not only do a program in PLC, also in Arduino or also in any type of microcontroller, right? Now we see the images. So this is the image, this is the setup. Now you see that this is the fixed gripper. So this is gripped. You see the sheet is already fed. Plastic sheet is a transparent sheet. So you can see the gripper cylinder here. You can see the tubings, right? So this is the cutter cylinder. The feeding cylinder will be behind the sheet. Now this is the start button. This is corresponding to, let me go back, X0. This is corresponding to X0. This one manual and auto switch. So this is X1. If X1 is now at present, it is off condition. That means it will work only once. If it is, if you push it downward, it will work continuously. Then for X2, X3, X4 and all, for X2, X3, X4 and all, I used as usual, I used the mixi button X2, X3, X4. Single, because this is really good, because I cannot switch on all the thing always on. It is not at all possible in the mixi type of switch. Either 2 is on or 3 is on or 4 is on. So that is why I chose this one. Okay, so we'll see the other view. So the sheet is fed this side. Now you see this is the feeder cylinder or moving for the moving cylinder, right? So all the electronics are here. So this is the moving cylinder. So this is the stroke. It can move. This moving member, sliding member, will move up from here to here. Okay. Now you see the cutter blade. Okay. Now we'll see the real working. You can hear the sound also, working sound also. I'll be also giving my commands. So you see the sheet once.
Okay, now it's auto mode.
Now it is auto mode. Now you see the movement. You see the cutter cylinder. Now you see the sheet is cut. Again I go back from this member. Cut 1, cut 2, cut 3, cut 4, 5, 50 piece, 60 piece, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, maybe in a matter of 10 seconds. So roughly, so roughly each operation takes nearly 1 to 1.3 seconds or so, right? So this is how you can make any product. It is a real machine, I'm saying. Okay, even this has been developed some 2 years back, right? So now you see the gripper cylinder here. Okay, so see, try to learn a modeling software, write a logic for working of this one. You can use any microcontroller. I used PLC for this. This is the PLC code. Okay, so I set the logic behind it using this, and I'm using this logic, and with the help of the simulation also I said about the working of this particular one. Okay, so everything is possible with the help of CAD and microcontroller. Okay, so I hope you understood two things simultaneously, both the SolidWorks as well as PLC programming here. Okay, so kind